Good morning to all of you. Yeah, just we'll wait for Dean sir. If he joins, then we'll start the session. Yes, sir. Sir, can we start the program, sir? Sir, your mic is muted. Sir, your mic is muted, sir. Sir, your mic is muted. So, let me, sir, 1 minute. Yeah, sir, now you can unmute.
Yes, yes.
Yes, sir.
Is it audible, Dr. Raja? Is it audible?
Sir, is it audible now?
Yes, yes, I am audible, but is it audible, my voice? I am audible to you?
Sir, your voice is not clear.
It is not clear.
Sir, am I audible now?
Yes, it is audible, but
Dean sir?
Yes. You allow me. You want to allow me now?
Pranab Tata sir, can you open your mic?
Yeah. Hello. Am I audible, Dr. Raja? Hello, Dr. Raja? Am I audible?
Doctor, sir, is audible?
Yes.
Dr. Raja, am I audible to you? Dr. Raja, am I audible to you?
Dr. Raja, am I audible to you?
Nipon? Nipon? Save lap.
Doctor,
Hello.
Yeah, now it is audible. Sir, can we start the program, sir?
Yes.
Good morning to all of you. Dear participant, we will start our program.
Bas tene ke koi
most respected Vice Chancellor of Central Agriculture University, Dr. Anupam Misra sir, and then most respected Director of Instruction, Dr. S. Basanta Singh sir, and our nodal officer, Professor B.N. Hazarika, Dean, College of Horticulture and Forestry, and the resource person of today's webinar, Dr. Pranab Datta, Associate Professor, and esteemed participant. So I welcome all of you for our 29th webinar, which is organized by College of Horticulture and Forestry under the program IDP NAHIP. So the title of our webinar is Technologies Based Organic Farming, Conservation and Sustainable Agriculture. So we have, it is a 2 days webinar. We have a broad topic which we have chosen, that is making better use of microbial resource for conservation of agriculture and sustainable crop cultivation. And the second lecture will be delivered by Mrinal Sharma. That title of the topic is the role of sustainable agriculture in production of biohydrogen as a clean biofuel. And the third lecture will be Miraj Alam Ansari, that is on organic farming technologies for sustainable agriculture. And the fourth topic will be delivered by Dr. Basanta Singh, scientist, soil science. The topic will be production and selection of different input materials required for organic farming. So more than 400 participants have registered for this program. So it is our 29th webinar. The topic is organic farming. It is a need of our, because of the demand is for more organic product in medicinal and even for vegetables and the fruits. So keeping in the demand of this entrepreneur seeker, we have decided this to conduct this topic on this organic farming for sustainable agriculture. So this program, today's program, I also welcome other associated members of this program. I also welcome Dr. Punapadi as an organizing secretary of this program, and also Dr. Victoria Devi, a coordinator, and co-coordinator Dr. N. Surmina Devi, assistant professor, and other co-coordinator Dr. Biswapati Devi. So I welcome all of you for our 29th webinar. Now, may I request our Dean sir to address this gathering. Sir.
Dr. Raja, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, audible, sir.
So let the resource person get introduced. Till then, I'll be ready for that.
Okay, sir. Dear participant, I would like to introduce the resource person once again. So today's morning speaker will be Dr. Pranab Datta, Associate Professor, Plant Pathology, School of Crop Protection, College of Postgraduate Studies in Agriculture Science and Central Agriculture University, IMPHAL. He will be delivering the topic on making better use of microbial resource for conservation of agriculture and suitable crop cultivation. So I would like to read his brief biodata. Our theme will be making better use of microbial resources for conservation of agriculture and suitable crop cultivation. Dr. Pranab Datta, Associate Professor, Plant Pathology, School of Crop Protection, College of Postgraduate Studies in Agricultural Science, Central Agriculture University, Umiam, Meghalaya. He has completed MSc and PhD in Biological Control from Assam Agriculture University, Jorhat, and postdoctorate on nanotechnology from FERA, UK. Published 100 research papers, 45 research abstracts, 13 proceeding papers, 82 popular articles, English, Bangla, and Assamese, 22 training manuals, handbooks, 45 book chapter, 9 practical manual, teaching aids, and 13 books edited, authored, and co-edited. Dr. Datta has planned and participated in delivered invited lectures at national and international conferences, as well as workshop organized by MISA, UCF, USA, ICPP 2018 at Boston. He's a recipient of DBT Overseas Associates Meritorious Contribution Award in Sericulture 2007 by Central Silk Board, ICPP 2018 Bursary Award by the American Phytopathological Society, USA, Young Scientist Award 2018, Distinguished Scientist Award 2019, Professor A.S. Bill Grammy Award 2016, Stanford Research Award 2015, Fellow of SBER, Society of Biocontrol Advancement, and so on. Established 2 lab, one on biopesticide production unit, Meghalaya, and nano lab at CAU, AAU, respectively. Dr. Datta developed 7 bioformulation, filed 5 patent, and commercialized 4 bioformulation. Actively involved in popularizing the bioformulation among the farming community of Northeast India, more particularly in Assam, Meghalaya, Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura, and so on. Pursued 16 externally funded projects of DBT, DST, and other country, Florida, USA, PCIL, IUS, RKBY, BRNS, ICAR, NBAIR, ICAR, NCI, PM, and so on. So with this introduction, I would like to brief about our activities also IDP NAHIP under the dynamic leadership of our Dean Sir, Professor B.N. Hazarika Sir. So he's a nodal officer of our IDP NAHIP project. His keen interest in promoting the entrepreneurship in the Northeast India. And he has advised to choose and also encouraging us to train this young entrepreneur through this Zoom mode. And we have wide sectors, areas, we have conducted these webinars, presently we are conducting bioformulation, mushroom, nursery production technology, even many of fruit production technology, post-harvest technology, even many other organic farming. So many other sectors of agriculture and horticulture we have been conducting. So thank you so much, sir. So now may I request our Dean sir to address this August gathering in this Zoom platform. Sir, please.
Am I audible to you, Dr. Raja? Dr. Raja, am I audible?
Audible, sir.
Okay. Oh, thank you very much, Dr. Raja. First of all, good morning to everyone. Our most respected Honorable Vice Chancellor of the prestigious Central Agricultural University, Dr. Anupam Mishra sir, who is the chief patron of this webinar program. Dr. S. Basanta Singh sir, Director of Instruction and also the PI of this project, the patron of this program. Our beneficent associate nodal officer, Dr. P. Raja. Our dynamic organizing secretary, Dr. Punavati Hesnam. Organizing secretary, Dr. Y. Disco Singh. Coordinator, Dr. Victoria Devi, Madam Bishapati Devi, and Dr. N. Surmina Devi. Our esteemed resource person, namely Dr. Pranab Datta from CPGS CAU Meghalaya, Dr. Minal Sharma from KRI New Delhi, and Dr. Basanta from ICAR Manipur Center, and Dr. Ansari from ICAR Modipuram. All the resource person and all the viewers present here in this webinar program. As our associate nodal officer has mentioned, this is the 29th webinar program conducted under the IDP NAHIP of the College of Horticulture and Forestry, Pasighat. So today we are having this very important topic for this webinar program, that is technologies based on organic farming, conservation and sustainable agriculture, which will be carried out on 13th and 14th of this month. And by the various eminent resource person, including Dr. Pranab Datta, who is having a vast experience in this area, and also the other resource persons. First of all, I thank everyone, all the resource person, for giving us time and consent for delivering their valuable lectures. I hope that during the course of deliberations, our viewers, particularly the students and other stakeholders, will be highly benefited out of it. And I, on my own behalf and on behalf of the College of Horticulture and Forestry as well as IDP group, I do welcome everyone and particularly convey our sincere regards to the all the resource persons of this program who will be delivering very valuable lectures on it. And I hope that during the course of deliberation of this 2 days program, definitely our stakeholder will be benefited, viewers will be benefited, more particularly the students who will be viewing this, it will be very benefited. You know, the organic farming is a very important topic nowadays, and particularly for the northeastern region, it is more important because we are trying to move from the green revolution to emerging revolution, and therefore a lot of issues are pending on agricultural farming technologies, and that is why this kind of webinar program will be definitely giving a thought and giving ideas to its viewers. I hope that during the course of this deliberation, everybody will be benefited. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity. Thank you, everyone. So have a nice lecture ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your address and encouraging the participant and motivating the participant to go for this organic farming and explaining the importance of organic farming in the northeastern country. Thank you so much, sir. Now I request Dr. Gunabadi. She is the organizing secretary of this 2 days webinar. She will be briefing about the brief activities and other things. I'll give the time to Dr. Punavadi, assistant professor and organizing secretary of this program. Madam.
Good Thank you so much, sir. First of all, a very good morning to our dean, sir, our P. Raja, sir. Then the resource person and all the members, organizing team, and to all the other participants. So the only mandatory of our webinar is to promote the organic farming in the northeastern region by applying or by using different developed technologies and enhance the livelihood in a very sustainable way with the aim of increasing the productivity by improving soil health and other all improvement of agro ecosystem. So now among these within this webinar, we are going to give such lecture by Dr. Pranab Datta by in making better use of microbial resources for conservation of agriculture and sustainable crop production. And in the second section, it will be by Dr. Mrinal Sharma, who is giving a role of sustainable agriculture in production of biohydrogen as a clean biofuel. And tomorrow morning section, the first section will be given by Dr. Tensubam Basanta Singh, which will delivering the topics on production and selection of different input materials required for organic farming. And tomorrow afternoon section will be given by Dr. Miras Alam Ansari, sir, which is going to deliver a lecture on organic farming technologies for sustainable agriculture. So we are very thankful to you all for attending these 2 days webinar based on organo technologies. Let's hope to join and learn it in a fruitful way and knowledge and be applied thinking with sustainable future. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Now I request Dr. Pranab Datta, Associate Professor, to start the session, sir. The platform is and over to you, please.
Am I audible?
Yes, audible.
Just a minute. Let me share my slides, okay? Okay, my slides are visible, Dr. Raja.
Yes, sir. Visible.
Can I start?
Yes, you can
start. Okay. So, good morning to one and all. So, respected Vice Chancellor of Central Agriculture University, Imphal, Dr. Anupam Mishra, sir. Director of Instruction, Dr. S. Basanta Singh, sir. Chairman cum Dean of College of Horticulture and Forestry. Co-Chairman, Dr. Raja. Organizing Secretary, Dr. Punavati Haisnam. And other organizing committee member like Dr. Singh, Dr. Victoria, then Dr. Sharmina. I thank, first of all, I would like to thank the organizing committee member, more particularly the Dean, the Dynamic Dean of College of Horticulture and Forestry, as well as other organizing committee member for giving me a chance to share my experiences on bioresources. So, now, as said by other speaker, that my topic is on making better use of microbial resources for the conservation of agriculture and sustainable crop production. So as we know, there is a worldwide swing toward the eco-friendly method of plant health management, as because the use of potential harmful chemical is viewed with dissatisfaction because of having numbers of harmful effect, not only to the human being, even to the, say, flora and fauna, okay, as well as the ecosystem. So recently, in different parts of the world, attention has been paid toward exploitation of the bioresources as novel therapeutic in the plant protection. And this is in view of their long-term effect on crop-based disease management, low cost, and safety to the ecosystems. out of the different bioresources, as we know, that plant, especially that botanicals, as well as the microbes, have the potential, that means that there is a huge potentiality to use it as a component of integrated pest management. So as we are from the Northeast, and our Northeast is bestowed with, okay, huge numbers of flora and fauna. Here I have cited a few examples only. We are gifted with 300 species of mammals, more than 900 species of birds, then more than 150 species of reptiles, 100 species of amphibians, and so on. Besides that, we are also gifted with 10,000 species of flowering plant, and out of that, and we are, that means, we have a good resources of more than 800 species of orchid. So as I said, there are different type of bioresources which are helping knowingly or unknowingly for the management of our ecosystem, besides managing the pest and diseases. So as we know, plants have been new for their medicinal and antimicrobial property since ancient times. And among around 5,280 plant species tested till to date by the different scientists of the world, so 1,134 species have been found to have insecticidal property. Besides that, more than 300 plant, that is around 346 plant, have been found to have this fungicidal activity, then 92 plant species antibacterial activity, and 90 have antiviral property. And this clearly indicated that plant kingdom is a vast storehouse of chemical that can check many plant pathogens without harming the ecosystem. Besides that, the microbial agent, which can be utilized for the management of better management of planting without harming the ecosystem with least cost, with the least cost and less damage to the environment, which can give us a sustainable crop production. So out of the different microbial agent to use as a biocontrol agent, so Trichoderma species, Pseudomonas, Bacillus, then entomopathogen like Beauheria, Mycorrhizium, then nematopathogenic fungus like Pestilomyces are mentionable. So my team, we are working on this exploitation of bioresources of this region since last 18 years. Okay, we started the work on exploitation of this type of resources with some by following some steps, and these steps can be utilized by many of the participants, more particularly say young budding scientists or the say research scholar or say student friend who have joined in this webinar. So we have started initially by survey and collecting the samples from the prevailing agroecological condition of the Northeastern region. Then we tried to isolate, characterize and identify through cultural, morphological and molecular tools. Then the that means another assignment came to us. We have to select the base strain. For that, we started some in vitro studies, the basic studies like dual culture test, then enzyme releasability test, biomass production, protein production, say like that. Then we this was followed by parasitism test. Then, as we know, our agriculture system or our say our soil is already dumped with huge numbers of chemicals. So we do not know whether this biocontrol agent, when will reach to our soil, whether they will be survived in presence of the in the chemocentric agriculture. So we started working on compatibility of our biocontrol agent with common biopesticides, common pesticides, or say common microbial agent that are surviving in the rhizosphere. Besides that, we studied the rhizosphere competence of our biocontrol agent, followed by root colonization ability, then study on endophytic behavior, then this was followed by activation of biochemical defense responses. This was followed by a small-scale field trial as well as your greenhouse test. Then we want to standardize a mass multiplication technique so that we can give a ready-made formulation to the end user, that is the farmers, who are the backbone of our agriculture. And this mass multiplication, we tried to standardize a mass multiplication technique with say low cost, with having the higher shelf life. This is also important. And where we have given concentration on the quality control measurement, especially virulence, viability, and your contamination to contamination. Then this type of technology were demonstrated among the end user, that is the farming community, in collaboration with the numbers of stakeholders. And when we got the feedback, that means after getting the feedback from the end users, the technology were refined. Then we tried to popularize among the end users of this region, and we proceeded for commercialization. So as I said, we have surveyed many areas, and we have collected soil samples, then samples of, say, a disease plant, where also we can see the growth of biocontrol agent. Then we collected cadavers, that infected infected cadavers with, say, different type of biocontrol agent. This is a photograph taken at Assam Agricultural University. Then that is Helicobarpa infected by pneumonia. Then Metrorhizium infected on the aphid. Then beetle infected by Viviaria bassiana. This is a very good science, and anybody can do it if they have some basic knowledge on the laboratory technique. They can isolate from here. As of that, my team, we have isolated more than 150 biocontrol agents, out of which 70 are Trichoderma species, and few say more than 20 are Metrorhizium, more than 70 species of Viviaria, like that. This is the list, this culture we are maintaining in our laboratory. And this culture has been deposited in the national repository like ITCC. Then while doing handling this type of biocontrol agent, we faced a problem, because the shelf life of this type of fungal biocontrol agent are very short, and it loses its virulence and viability without repeated subculturing in, say, particular media or passing through the host in case of, say, entomopathogenic fungus. But my dear participant, but the repeated subculturing, okay, this repeated subculturing causes, that means involvement of huge cost, as well as continuous involvement of scientists and resource scholars, is utmost important. Again, after 3 to 4 subcultures, they lose their viability and virulence. We also tried for lyophilization, okay, but this lyophilization or this technique causes breakdown of the fungal spores. Ultimately, what happened? Ultimately, at field condition, the bioformulation prepared from the lyophilized product shows erratic result. So my team, we have developed an efficient, low-cost method for preserving fungal biocontrol agent in liquid state without any change in the viability and virulence against the target pest and pathogen. We named it Surakshi. Okay, here, if we preserve, if you want to preserve your culture will be safe up to 44 months. And the patent has been filed, and it is in the last stage. So within this year, probably I am expecting the final patent number. Okay. So though I have mentioned numbers of biocontrol agent, but here as the time is limited, only 40 to 50 minutes. So within this time period, I will try to cover only the work done by my team, especially on two organisms, Trichoderma and Mitorhizium. But I will not discuss on the work which we have done in other biocontrol agent. Let us start with the Trichoderma, which has been considered as a potential biocontrol agent, as because these are, as we know, these are free living fungi, which are highly interactive in the root, soil, and the foliar environment. And almost all the Trichoderma species compete for the seed exudates and nutrient as well as space. This type of biocontrol agent also can be used as a biofertilizer for their very good ability of solubilizing numbers of nutrient. That thing I'm going to discuss in my later slides, and also can be used as a fertility promoter. Some strain of this species, this genus, Trichoderma, have the ability to colonize and penetrate the root tissues as symbiont, and they can lead to induced systemic resistance and help in stimulation of the plant growth. And my dear participant, you please try to remember mycoparasitic mechanism together with effective defense mechanism induced in the plant are considered as the key factor for success of this species, genus Trichoderma. This type of species also have the ability to inhibit or the degrade pectinases and other enzymes that are utmost essential for the plant pathogenic fungi for infection. So here I am showing only one species of Trichoderma for which we have submitted to the gene bank the accession number. If you want to assess it, you just go to the NCBI website and click it, and you will get the all the information related to Trichoderma hariginum. This species we have isolated from Meghalaya. Okay, so this type of Trichoderma species, we studied their efficacy against few pathogens, especially soil-borne plant pathogens like Rhizoctonia, Sclerotinia, then Sclerotium, then Fusarium. Besides that, against nematode, Melodogyne, then another two pathogens like Colletotrichum and Cercospora. Now, question may arise is, why we have targeted this organism? Because in our region, these organisms are creating havoc to the for cultivation of many plant pathogens. Besides that, soil-borne organisms like Rhizoctonia, Sclerotinia, and Sclerotium they produce is sclerotia, which are very difficult to control with the with the recommended pesticides, because they produce sclerotia. Sclerotia are very tough in nature. They are compact mass of hyphae. After application of this type of chemical, recommended chemical, they can kill 1 to 2 layer. Beyond that, they cannot reach to the say inner core of the sclerotia. That's why most of the chemical fail to control such type of plant pathogen. Initially, we did a series of in vitro studies that ameliorate us to identify the most potential strain of Trichoderma species, either against pathogen or soil-borne plant pathogen, Rhizoctonia or Sclerotinia, or say Fusarium and other organism, as well as nematode. Okay. And huge work has been done against different type of pathogen by different type of biocontrol agent. Even we tried the efficacy of entomopathogenic fungus for the management of soil-borne plant pathogen. We also tried nematopathogenic fungus against soil-borne plant pathogen and other plant pathogen, so that we can get a good potential strain with having the multiple effect. Okay. So beside that, we also studied whether they have the ability to release some volatile and non-volatile compound. Yes, and we have found few strain of the biocontrol agent, especially Trichoderma hirsutinum, they have the ability to release both the thing, that is volatile as well as non-volatile compound, which are of great importance in the management of soil-borne plant pathogen. Beside that, we also studied the mode of action of this type of species, and we have found competition for the food. Okay, then mycoparasitism, lysis, then antibiosis are the main mechanism of this type of biocontrol agent for the suppression of the plant pathogen. Here, lysis means breakdown of the hyphal cell of the pathogen. Okay, this is the diagram. This is the photograph of lysis, and this is called coiling. Okay, by coiling, they because of coiling, the pathogen failed to branched more. Okay. Then at the joining point of the coiling, they used to release some antibiotic. Because of this release, they cause lysis of the pathogen cell, as shown in this photograph. More closer photograph I want to show here, that this is the coiling by one species of Trichoderma on the pathogen. Okay, then this is called lysis, where breakdown of the cell is very prominent. Okay, at the branching point, as well as they have the ability to cause formation of the hole. Because of the formation of the hole, the nutrient that are present inside the host cell of the, that is pathogen, it comes out, and that are utilized by the biocontrol agent for their further growth and development. Up till that, it was okay, but it was not known what will happen when this type of biocontrol agent goes to the soil. Definitely, my dear participant, definitely they will face the complex nature of the rhizosphere. And it will definitely face the presence of commonly used agrochemicals like herbicide, fungicide, insecticide. So my team, we have studied the compatibility of our biocontrol agent with other rhizospheric biocontrol agent, as well as other agrochemicals. Initially, we have tested the compatibility of 14 different fungal and bacterial biocontrol agent with each other, and we have found there is no harmful effect on each other. This was further confirmed through the microscopic studies on the inoculum, especially conidia and mycelium, as well as protein content and biomass production ability of the biocontrol agent. And ultimately, it helped us to develop one idea, that is that concept of consortial formulation with multiple function. I mean to say here, suppose 2 to 3 biocontrol agents, say one antagonist, fungal antagonist effective against plant pathogen, another is entomopathogenic, which will take care of the, say, insect pest, and nematopathogen, we will take care of the nematode. That means 3 type of biocontrol agents, if we combine and we apply in a particular field, they can take care of the same thing with the same, sorry, different thing with same formulation. It will also reduce the cost of cultivation of a particular crop. Beside that, many a times we faced a question that whether this type of biocontrol agent are compatible with other inorganic fertilizer. Yes, that was a big question from the farmer's side. Initially, we didn't have any idea. So we started working on this, and we studied the compatibility of Trichoderma species with 4 different commonly used agrochemicals at 4 doses, 0.1 to 0.2%. And up to, say, urea SSP and MOP, these were found to be compatible up to 2% of this 2% concentration with Trichoderma. But calcium ammonium nitrate, okay, this was found to be compatible only up to 0.1%. And thereby, we could not able to see their compatibility reaction. From this table, we can say, if anyone want to use the combinedly okay, fertilizer as well as trichoderma, they can use the chart and they can apply this thing in their crop field. Besides that, 25 different agrochemicals, mostly insecticide, fungicide, then your herbicide and some stickers were tested at different doses for their compatibility with trichoderma. And we have found few chemicals like methomyl, then thymethoxim, diphenthiouran, and say herbicide like glyphosate and fungicide like mancozeb at sublethal or sub-sublethal dose, these are compatible. And many studies also suggested that the use of chemical method in parallel or in combination with the biological control agent may have an impact on the durability of the ecosystem of certain biocontrol agent. Besides that, to prepare a formulation of a particular biocontrol agent, we need sticker, adjuvant, osmoticant, spreader, UV protectant. So, but we didn't have any idea. So we have tested different different concentration. We have found at some doses or some concentration, these are compatible with this type of biocontrol agent. As I said, we are from Northeast, and our Northeast soil, the acidic is nature, and in acidic soil, aluminum and iron toxicity is a big problem. So again, we didn't have any idea whether Trichoderma harginum, when we will apply in the soil, whether they can survive in the higher concentration of aluminum and iron. So we started working on that, and we have tested around 0 to 100 ppm concentration for your aluminum, then 0 to 300 ppm concentration of your iron, and we have seen up to say 100, up to 70 ppm Trichoderma harginium they are compatible with your aluminium chloride or say aluminium, but highest biomass we could able to record at 60 ppm. In case of iron, that highest biomass we could able to record in 170 ppm. And later on, that is beyond that, that is 200, 250, 275, and 300 ppm, the growth, that is biomass, was a little bit decreasing. Okay. Beside that, Trichoderma harginium was also tested, whether they could able to grow in different pH. We have tested the pH from 3 to 6.5, and there was no, that means during our study, we have seen with the increase of pH, the growth was found to increasing, but further study on the higher pH is also going on. After 3 to 4 months, we can give the answer of many questions regarding the tolerance of Trichoderma harginium at higher pH. Besides that, the functional attribute of Trichoderma harginium were also studied, because we want an organism with having the multiple actions. So we started working on caseinase activity, alpha amylase activity, and chitinase activity, and we found positive effect. That means they have the ability to degrade caseinase, alpha amylase, and chitinase, but they do not have the ability to solubilize phosphate, but they have the positive reaction on the zinc solubilization. Further, we also tested, we have found positive action on the ammonia production, CDRO4 production up to 90.81 unit, and specific CDRO4, which have a specific function in the plant, like catecholate, hydroxymate, and carboxylate. These are found to be, that means they showed this Trichoderma strain, but I have isolated and deposited in the gene bank. They have positive, that means they could have the ability to produce this type of CDRO4, like catecholate, hydroxymate, and carboxylate. Then endophytic colonization was also studied, whether they can survive inside the plant. If they survive, how? Because the endophytic ability is a very important factor, because if an organism survive inside the plant as an endophyte, they can activate the defense mechanism of the host plant. Because of activation of the defense mechanism, the other organism, okay, non-target organism also cannot attack our crop plant. And we studied for field work. Okay, that work I will show you in later to my slides. Okay, where we have seen Trichoderma can could able to recovered that isolates of this Trichoderma up to 64%, because they could able to colonize up to 64% of the stems, but we could not able to isolate from roots. Okay, they could also survive inside the seeds, right? Again, when the seed germinate along with the plumulan radicle, they also, their growth also was seen in plumulan radicle. Beside that, we have observed the presence of mycelium strain and conidia of this species in the intercellular species of crop plant. So that was up to say laboratory and little bit field work. So beside that, further field work and the farmer's field work, that work I will share in my later slides. Another species, Metrorhizium, which is an entomopathogenic fungus, which is also known as mighty fungus. Okay, and this is popularly known as green muscardine fungus. Our team, we have also worked on Metrorhizium with around 24 isolates. Okay, and when they cause infection to a particular insect, initially they look like this the whitish growth on the infected parts, either coxa, trochanter, femur, tibia, or say your head, thorax, and abdomen. But afterwards, the whole infected insect, it turns to olive green color. So it has a huge numbers of target species, say more than 200 species they can attack that belongs to 50 family. So our group, we have initially started working on say aphid, because aphid is a big problem for because it actually spread the viral disease in many crops. So beside that, we also tested the efficacy of Metrorhizium on termite, and initially we did some in vitro bioefficacy test to standardize the dose as well as to understand the mechanism. During our study, we have seen entomopathogen, so like Metrorhizium and Beauharia, forget about the Beauharia, I will discuss on the Metrorhizium. They as and when they fall on the say insect surface, if the conditions are okay, they germinate. Okay, initially adhere to the body surface, they germinate, then they enter inside the host cell. Okay, then they try to ramify the whole that is body cell. Okay, that thing further we have proved through some microscopy study. Then they grow profusely by utilizing the hemolymph, because hemolymph acts as a good source of the nutrient, which are actually helpful for the growth and development of this Metrorhizium and Soplea. And they enter into the hemocell, where they produce blastospores, and after forming the blastospores, they come out from the insect body. And here I want to show that when it applied this type of Metrorhizium on the termite body, we have seen termite died within 72 hours of application, and fungal structure with conidia were blast out from the termite body within 7 days of its application. This was further proved through electron microscopy study. This is the termite infected with Metrorhizium, where addition and the growth of Metrorhizium is prominent. Then penetration, then growth inside the body, then ramification of the whole body parts. And these are the conidia and conidiophore, which we have taken photograph from the internal part of that insect. Okay. Beside that, we also tested, as I said, on the aphid. This is the healthy aphid on the electron microscopy study. And this is the aphid which are already infested by Metrorhizium, and actually deformed aphid after infestation of the Metrorhizium. We have seen that the similar growth of the growth of conidiophore and conidia inside the host cell, that is aphid, in case of this study. We have seen that the ventral cuticle and abdominal have distorted with deformation of all the body parts. Abnormalities was also seen in the cuticle and sensory systems. We also observed were clearly visible throughout the body of the infested aphid, and this suggests that the fungal growth can cause serious damage to the pest, disturbing its major physiological activities, resulting in its death. Then we further did some in vitro assay to standardize the dose of its application. We tested from 10 to the power 1 to 10 to the power 12 concentration, and we got 10 to the power 8, 1 into 10 to the power 8 spores per ml is the standardized, that means effective dose for application of Metrorhizium anisopoly for our strain. We also tested the compatibilities as similar to your Trichoderma harzinia with 25 different agrochemicals, and few agrochemicals have shown compatible with Metrorhizium and simply at some doses. The good information is that both the strain Trichoderma as well as Metrorhizium, they do not have any harmful effect on beneficial insect like honeybee, predator like say praying mantid, then our friend or the farmer's friend, that is earthworm, and parasitoid like Trichogamma chylonis and Japonicum. They are safe from this infection of Trichoderma as well as Metrorhizium and simply. We did some work on say in organic tea garden, where we applied Metrorhizium in vermicompost unit, and the end user said that because of application of this Metrorhizium in anisopoly at the time of composting, they could able to harvest their vermicompost 7 to 8 days ahead. Then we did further study where we have seen this Mycorrhizium, and so because of the application of the Mycorrhizium encephaly, the reproduction ability or the reproductibility of the earthworm increased. We got higher, that means faster growth of earthworm in the applied tank. And these are also safe for this type of beetle, where the aphid was there and we applied on the aphid and the aphid were died, but the beetles were safe. They are happily moving here and there, and they are, that means, taking these infected aphids as food. Then we proceeded for formulation. Okay, where, as I said, we developed two different type of formulation. One was solid and liquid, and both were supplemented with some sticker, carrier, adjuvant, and UV protectant. And during our study, we have seen the performance of liquid formulation is better than the solid formulation. So from this slide onwards, I will discuss on the liquid-based formulation. So we standardized the protocol for liquid formulation with the isolates of Assam as well as other northeastern state. And these are some of the photographs of trichoderma-based formulation with a shelf life of 16 months. We tested the efficacy as a seed treating agent. These are the seed of maize treated with trichoderma-based bioformulation. These are the seed which were non-treated, and where we can see the fungal growth, like whitish growth, as well as the growth of aspergillus on the untreated seed. Ultimately, this type of seed will not survive in the field in the coming days. Okay, as I said, sclerotia is the main, that means structure by which Rhizoctonia or say soil-borne plant pathogen, they survive. We also tested the efficacy on this type of sclerotia. And during our study, we have seen the sclerotia failed to germinate after treating with trichoderma-based bioformulation, where sclerotia, in case of control, they could able to germinate. So I'm showing only one photograph, but a lot of work has been done so that our student friend, they can also do this type of work. Then we proceeded to a small-scale pilot field trial where we have combined trichoderma-based bioformulation with, say, another biofertilizer. And we use this type of product as a seed treating agent, soil application, as well as foliar application thrice at an interval of 15 days till your flowering starts. And we have seen good seed germination, around 99.7% germination in case of treated seed. And we got faster root growth, shoot growth, as well as early 7 days early flowering. This is the initial stage. And these are some of the stages after 10 days of treating the seedlings, where we could be able to see that means faster growth and more roots in case of treated seeds. And we got very less percentage of the disease in case of, say, treated plot as compared to control. And we also, as I said, we got profuse tillering in the treated plot. We got higher panicle, then less disease incidence, and 7 days early flowering in the treated plot. And this is the plot where at the harvesting stage. And from this experiment, we have seen this type of product due to the use of by using a seed treating agent, soil application, or seedling treatment, as well as foliar application, they could able to reduce the disease incidence of seed blight, seed rot, and seed blight, seed rot by 70%. And we could not able to, we have not recorded any type of infection by the brown spots. We got 29.82% more yield as compared to the control. So this type of product has also tested for organic cultivation of black turmeric, which is a high value at the international market. And this was the package, rhizome treatment with Umtrico at the rate 10 ml per liter for 30 minutes, followed by shed drying, plus foliar spray 10 ml per liter thrice at 21 days interval. And this could able to reduce the dreaded disease like Colletotrichum in the farmer's field with positive effect on plant growth parameter as well as in yield. So another success story we do have, this work we did in Barpeta for organic cultivation of strawberry. And here the seedlings were treated with trichoderma-based bioformulation, that is Umtrico. Then soil application was done with Andes compost at 300 kg per acre, seedling root dip treatment with 10 ml per liter, and foliar spray were done. And this farmer could able to earn more than, say, 1.75 lakh per acre with having very less disease incidence of botrytis, fruit rot, or say mites. And the success story has been documented, and we have submitted, we are going to submit to our authority. So after doing all this type of work, always we used to do the organoleptic test to take the feed as well as the feedback from the farmers. And we are also doing the impact analysis to understand how much that means it has given profit to our end users. What is the that means up to what extent they could able to reduce the use of chemical pesticides and many more. So the success stories has been covered by many newspapers of the northeastern regions. And so I would like to thank all the news reporter who has helped us to popularize this type of product among the farming community of our region. Beside that, we also worked on, as I said, on Metrizium. Initially, we produced two type of formulation. And this this product I have developed in my last service period at Assam Agricultural University, where I worked up to 2020. So I would like to thank my earlier authority, especially AAU's authority, who helped me for such type of work. And these are some of the product formulated packeted product in my lab. So this product were tested against termite, aphid, white grub, scale insect, and coxsackie grub, and we have filed patent for this one. So they are initially we tested their efficacy in different area, say in four districts of Assam and three districts of West Bengal against termite as well as management of aphid in tea ecosystem. So I will share one of my story on management of the termite. So here initially we have we did that experiment in 3 hectare area. Initially the whole experimental plot were cleaned properly. Then the area were irrigated through sprinkler irrigation prior to the application of this type of formulations. And these are some of the view how we prepared the spray solution with the garden laborers and the authority of their gardens. And we applied this type of formulation at 1:10^6 spore per ml along with sticker thrice at an interval of 30 days. And we spraying thoroughly, and due care was taken at the time of spraying so that the spray solution of Metrizium simply covers all the infected plant parts, then soils, termite oil, etc. And beside that, we also sprayed the shade tree because the tea plantation have shade trees. Okay, they love shades. Okay, so these shade trees were also sprayed up to a height of 10 feet. And these are some of the view how we sprayed in that area. And these are the that was infested area by infested plant or the bushes by termite. Okay, and even we sprayed in the termite mound, right? And after application of Metrizium and Soply on the infested branches, these tea bushes which were infested with termites were also cement plastered after application, as I said, of our formulation. Besides that, after completion of third spray, the 500 gram of vermicompost was applied around the tea bushes, and over that vermicompost we sprayed Metrizium and Soply. Okay, then we started taking the observation on development of new termitarium built in the soil or on the plant or the new infestation within the treated area. Okay, this were taken from the 60 days of final spraying till the final harvest, and yields were also recorded in the plot at the end season. And you see I'm happy to share with you that we could not able to see new termitarium or the termites in the treated plot up to 1 year of its application. Okay, observation after say 60 days of spray showed only few new termitarium built up in already existing mound. So mounds were there. The mounds were of having around 5 feet height and around 6.5 feet width. Okay, then tea bushes were also observed to regain their growth with good crop. Okay, then new branches were also seen come out from the lower part of the tea bushes. These are some of the view after 3 months and 6 months. So in that area, beside say getting less infestation of the termite, we also observe less infestation of the pest like aphid, scale insect, red spider mite, and halopeltis. The reason was not known. So we started working on the endophytic nature of the Metrizium on the tea bushes. Okay, and we could able to recover these endophytes from the stems, roots, as well as leaves. But it was these are some of the good photographs of recovery from the leaves, the recovery from the shoots as well as roots. But we didn't know how they are surviving inside the host plant. So we did some light as well as electron microscopy study, and where we have seen the ramification. That means they can survive by producing mycelium or the conidia, and many a times by chlamydospore inside the host cell. This type of study initially we did with the help of light microscopy, okay, and then followed by electron microscopy. And this study helped us to understand many mechanisms that involve for not getting the infestation of other pests beside the targeted one. But till to that, we didn't know whether the re-isolated Metrorhizium was similar with the original one. So we started working on confirming identity of the two isolates, that is original as well as re-isolate. And from our molecular study, molecular approach, we have seen these are actually both are same, of same base pair. This was found to be, that means almost 100% identity with each other. And from that area, that means that experiment we did for 3 years continuously. From that area, we tried to study their effect on soil biological and physical chemical property in two garden, experimental garden for plantation crop of Assam Agricultural University and Banaspati Tea Estate of Golaghat of district of Assam, who are following this organic cultivation since last 32 years. Here we have seen the positive effect on NPK, then exchangeable cation like calcium, magnesium, sodium, potassium, then organic carbon percentage as well as total biomass carbon. They have the positive effect as compared to untreated one. We did this, we have taken the observation for the soil of 15 centimeter as well as 30 centimeter depth. So we standardize a module. Now it becomes a regular practice for that garden as well as many garden of Assam as well as West Bengals for the management of termite. So again, we did another experiment on management of the termite, okay, and that experiment named as efficacy of different bioformulation of Metrorhizium insipidus against adult termite, okay, in Banaspati Tea Garden. So for this study, we have selected 3 active mound with sufficient termite population. 2 different type of formulation, one was liquid and solid, were applied at a concentration of 1:20/6 conidia per ml. Along with that, we added one sticker. Okay, for this work, one of the entomologists of Assam Agricultural University, Dr. Bhattacharya, he helped me a lot. So for this work, initially we make 5 hole per mound with a depth of 10 feet and 200 liter of bioformulation per mound were applied with 3 applications, and 3 applications were done at 30 days interval. As in Assam, adult termite are generally seen to fly during 15 to 25th April since last many years, okay? So nylon nets with having the size of 50 mesh was fitted covering all the openings or hole of the termite mound. And 5 nylon nets were fitted per termite mound. And we fitted 5 electric bulb of 100 watt, okay, per termite mound over the nylon net during the night times. And observation on adult termite flying out from each of the inoculated termite mound was recorded. This is the view during daytime, this is the view in the nighttime. And we spent many days, many nights in this garden. Per month, we used to spend around 20 days to take this observation. Ultimately, after doing a lot of work, we have seen that the liquid bioformulation have the ability to reduce the adult population by 81% as compared to solid formulation 55%. So this type of work we also did against the aphid. We tested and we got good result. So I will not discuss too much because around 20 minutes left for me. So these are some of the photographs of aphid, dyed aphid after application of Metrorhizium in the farmer's field conditions. And beside this type of bioformulation, you people or the participant scientist or say our student friend can try Buvaria based bioformulation for the management of soft-bodied insect or say vector of many viral diseases as well as coleoptera and pest, okay, and they are eco-friendly management. We did few work. These are some of the photograph I am showing. So in a garden, we got a challenge for the integrated management of say a number of pests, starting from red rust, then algal problem, then slug, then semi-looper, many more. So he's the man, Mr. Vikas Joshi. Who is the garden manager, he came with this problem. Initially, he has given a challenge of 1 hectare area along with the scientist of entomology, soil scientist, and scientist of tea husbandry and technology, we formulated an integrated module based on our experience on compatibility. Because as I said, few chemicals are compatible with each other. So we combined chemical as well as biocontrol agent, as well as fungal antagonist like Trichoderma, and say entomopathogen like Metrorhizium, Beaveria, etc. And this practice, generally with that module to apply in a particular field, it takes around 60 days. But for tea, we should not worry because tea is a perennial crop. A particular crop, as a particular plant or the tea bush can survive up to 75 to 100 years. So we didn't worry about this time take, to be taken for this type of work. Here what we did, initially the field sanitation was done, then we tried to create some good aeration among the tea bushes, then we used trap for preparation which was painted with bright yellow color, and over that we put grease over it and fixed it at 1.5 feet above the tree table, okay, tea table, and per 15 feet at an interval of 15 feet we have fitted this type of trap, okay, in the whole garden in 1 hectare area. Then we started working on that. After two years we have seen the pest incidence was reduced by 70.67%, and they could able to harvest the crop 7 to 10 days ahead as compared to other crop. And they reported that unproductive tea bushes with a healthy flash, and the manager, he tested this one for antioxidant property, and he have seen they got higher antioxidant property in the this plot. And garden, more importantly, garden laborer got relief from the disturbance of the white fly that otherwise entered into the nose and causes vomit. Okay, ultimately they could able to relief from this type of problem. And in this garden, they reduced the use of pesticide by 50%. Now it becomes a regular practice for 450 hectare area of that garden. Initially we started in 1 hectare area. The success is that now it become a regular practice for 450 hectare area of that garden. And this is a now beautiful garden, okay, with beautiful tea leaves, okay. Anybody can visit this garden. Name of the garden is Numoligar Tea Estate, okay, of Golaghat district. Same type of, this type of module we also tested in the brinjal, especially in Lower Assam, okay, to manage the problem faced by brinjal cultivator, which is the main crop for Lower Assam, okay, which is faced by number of plant as well as plant pathogen as well as diseases. We tested in different farmers field where we got good result in case of say organic carbon, then bug density, then water holding capacity, and microbial biomass carbon, besides reducing the pest as well as diseases in that farmers field. Here that seedling as well as soil were applied with some of the bioformulation, but foliar spray was done with the consortial formulations of compatible biocontrol agent like Trichoderma hygienum, Beaveria abyssiana, and Metrorhizium insipidus, okay, to reduce the cost. And this is a pilot field, this is a study that is ongoing study in my campus, and we are trying against fall armyworm. That means here we are trying to integrating some of the chemical insecticide with the biopesticide, and this is the result. Here our researchers, they sprayed on the infected larvae of fall armyworm. After 3 days, they could able to get this type of infestation in their field. And more work on, say, evaluation of synergistic effect of insecticide Metrorhizium, especially on sucking pest of rice, is also going on. This is my team. At present, they are helping me a lot, so I should thank all of them. So this type of work also has been done by one of the scientists. Now she is the organizing secretary's webinar, Dr. Punapati Haisnam. She tested at the environmental condition of Arunachal Pradesh, where she also could able to get good harvest, good plant growth promoting activity, as well as lower disease incidence and 50 days early flowering in the treated plot as compared to untreated one. Very recently, three of our product developed at Central Agriculture University has been recommended by ICAR to test it in 4 different center at IIHR Hasarghatta, then Pune, that is Mahatma Phule Krishi Vidyapeeth Pune, then Assam Agriculture University Kahikusi, that is Guwahati, and at ICAR Directorate of Floriculture, that is Pune. So this type of product will be tested for next 3 years. Then the result, what type of result they will share, I don't know. So time will say. So we try to popularize this type of product through demonstration. We covered many crops. Some of the photograph I have showing for the management of number of diseases I have mentioned in the right hand side of my presentations. So we tested this type of product in the hilly terrains for the organic cultivation of many crops, starting from vegetables, then paddy, then maize, then ginger, and many more. We also tested in case of protected cultivation for to get rid of the disease faced by our floricultural plant, as well as some vegetables. We distributed huge quantity of biopesticide to the farming community of Meghalaya, Assam, then almost all the northeastern part. We demonstrated on the method of application of the biopesticide by moving door to door. Okay, because without that, it is not easy to convince them. Okay, and if they do not know the actual method of application, then our the product will may not show good result in the field conditions. And for such type of thing, we always encourage women farmer to involve more and more. So now farmers of many of our area, they are producing vegetables by utilizing the biopesticide product of Central Agriculture University. Some of the view I am showing with you. Some of the photograph here also I'm showing for you. Okay, so this technology we want to transfer to the say most among the scientists of our region, as well as national level, as well as the among the research scholars. So we started working on skill development training so that farmers or say scientists, they can come here, they can see the technology, they can prepare the bioformulation, and ultimately it will help for its making available its availability among the rural area of all the northeastern states. We tried to popularize this type of technology through publication in newspapers, then radio talk, TV, in different languages. Okay, then for ready references, we prepared huge quantities of extension bulletin in different languages, in Khasi, English, Bangla, Assamese. Okay, and we used to give the farmers so that they it can act as a ready reckoner at the time of using the biopesticide formulation of Central Agriculture University as well as Assam Agriculture University. Further, we prepared audio visual aids, especially CD. So for this, one of my faculty, one of my project staff, he helped me a lot. So we prepared this type of audio visual aids for the farmers in easy language, so that it can be seeing is believing. When they will see the technology, how to prepare the solution, how to treat the seed, how to prepare the compost, then it will become very easy for them to apply in their field also. Over the year, we have imparted more than imparted training to 1400 farmers, 80 extension functionaries of different states of northeastern states, 120 scientists, faculties, and SMS of the national level institutes, then 60 tea garden managers, and we distributed more than 1,000 liters of bioformulations. But after, distributing this type of bioformulation, or after spreading this type of technology among the scientists or, say, farmers' friend, regular scouting or regular field visit is important so that we can help them at each and every step of their work. So we used to visit the farmers' field regularly even at this pandemic situation. And regular field visits, as I said, help the farmers to that means raise faith on us as well as technology, right? So as I said, regular monitoring, and because many a times after application of this type of product, farmers may face some of the unforeseen say problem. So to mitigate this type of problem, we have to visit regularly. This is one of my requests to young scientists as well as our students, friends who are going to get job after a few years. So we try to involve more and more students so that they can and be a reference in the coming days. These students are nowadays the backbone for our future science. So when they will be convinced that this type of technology, on this type of technology, they will work on the coming days, and they will also promote this type of technology during their ages among the farming community. So as I said, we used to take the feedback from the farmers, and it has shown that the farmers got the higher seed germination, then higher plant growth parameter, higher yield, then good shelf life, good market price, and besides maintaining the pest and disease, it also maintains the quality of the soil with reduction of pest and disease in eco-friendly way. This is one of my demonstration area that is going on. It is in the harvesting stage. So they cultivated their whole area, especially potato in a big area, around 6 acre and, of potato with, through application of our productions, our the biopesticides. So this type of technology has already been included. Okay, the 6 technology which has been developed by my team has been included in the organic package and practice for selected crops of Assam, and it has been included by Assam Agriculture University and Department of Agriculture of Government of Assam. 4 product already been commercialized through a company, Green Biotech Eco Solution Private Limited. Now they are selling this product through 82 outlets. And another company from West Bengal, they are also producing this type of product by utilizing our strain. So beside that, the young scientists, they can work, they can utilize this type of bioresources, especially microbes as well as plant, for the synthesis of nanoparticle, because the coming era will be nano era. So because the nanoparticle, if you are going to use, it will reduce the pesticide use by 99%, because at very small quantity, they are very much effective for the management of number of pest and diseases with good, that means defense activation ability. This is my experience. Since last 14 years, I'm one of my team. They are also, a few of my team members, they are also working on nanoparticles. So we standardized the biogenic synthesis of silver nanoparticle through trichoderma species. We characterized through different type of equipment like UVB spectrophotometer, DLS, FTIR, then jetasizer, then and many more, and electron micrography. And we have tested against mainly 2 pathogens. Number one is Rhizoctonia solani and Xanthomonas oryzae. And we have found even at 100 ppm concentration, they can kill the pathogen as compared to 3000 or the 4000 ppm of say other recommended pesticide. So whatever it may be, the biopesticide, whatever we have developed, this has been now as of date, these are using by different parts of the Northeast, and this is highlighted with some blinked dot. And this type of bioformulations have a lot of advantage because they are eco-friendly, they prepare with the indigenous strains and easy to establish in the environment of Northeast, and they are compatible with each other, and they have the ability to produce siderophore. Besides promotion of the plant growth, they also curb the problem of pest as well as other bad things. There are a huge scope of utilizing this type of microbial resources because it will grow more due to the ban of pesticide and the increases in the demand of organic food, more particularly after corona pandemic. So that's why people are concentrating on use of organic pesticides. And to meet the demand, meet the increased market demand for organic food, the growers, they are motivated towards production of organic food. And organic food, that is a common notion, organic food increases the immunity against dreaded ailment. Okay, and then nowadays people are becoming more and more concerned about the environment, so preference of the biopesticide is increasing day by day. And in the coming days, more industry will come up and it will open up new employment opportunity for many more. This type of bioresources or say microbial resources is also considered as a important component of soil health management, because it promotes the natural resources based integrated sustainable farming that ensures maintenance of the soil fertility, conservation of the biodiversity, minimize the dependencies of external input, reduce the cost of farming, then increase the net income, then it promotes the sustainability, okay, it protect the environment, empower the farmers, and it help in the development of entrepreneurs among the farmers. In the coming days, more studies are needed to determine the environmental effect of this type of biogen on the environment and other plant. Okay, more study to be done. The integration of biopesticides or say microbial pesticide with botanical pesticide, which has a lot of potential in the pest management, but CIB is not permitting. But the knowledge can be gathered, and this type of thing we can test. Who knows, in the coming days, CIB may permit. Okay, after releasing of the pesticide management bill, which has been already submitted to the parliament for its approval. After that, we may expect that the combination of the biopesticide along with the botanical pesticide, and that the enhancement of potential of the biocontrol agent, so protoplast fusion, that is another area of research. And these microbes can be utilized, as I said, for synthesis of nanoparticle, especially biogenic synthesis of nanoparticle. So over the time, this type of biocontrollagen, okay, number of biocontrollagen and some of the botanicals of our region, we have exploited for the synthesis of silver, then zinc, then copper, titanium oxide, as well as gold nanoparticle. Okay. So with the help of metallurgy, we synthesize gold nanoparticle, we characterize and we test it for the management of blast uprise with a very good effect and without having any bad effect on the plant growth parameter and the biochemical property of the plant. So we also studied, because while working on with this type of nanoparticle, especially say silver, gold, or say a zinc oxide, always scientists, they used to raise one question, whether these are safe to the human being. So to give the answer of this type of question, we started working on this mammalian toxicity. For that, we have selected the varicocele of African monkey. Okay, and probably you know this. This type of cell are these varicocele are more or less similar with the human cells, and this type of cells are very much adherent type, anchorage dependent, and continuous mammalian cell line. This work we did in collaboration with Department of Microbiology of Soil, College of Veterinary Science. Okay, and during this study we have seen with the increase at three different concentration, 50, 100 and 200 ppm concentration we have tested, especially for silver nanoparticle and zinc oxide nanoparticle. Here we have seen with the increase of concentration, the that means uptake of nanoparticle increase within the cell. When we studied the interrelation property, so at 200 ppm concentration, it can interrelate within the cell. Okay. Then we studied through this electron microscopy study, where we have seen up to 100 ppm, there was no distortion on the cell. But after, say, 100 ppm, it is at 200 ppm, cell integrity were totally found to be distorted. Like that, we did many study, but the time is almost finished. So I will not share that type of thing, and someday I will share. So here we have seen at lower concentration, especially up to 100 ppm concentration of silver nanoparticle, these are safe to the human, that is varicocele or mammalian cell. But beyond that, it have some mild toxicity. Okay. So these are the product, nanoproduct we have synthesized by utilizing the microbe. Beside that, in Assam, one leaf, one plant is there that is called Bhedailata, and scientifically it is known as Pederia foetida, which is used by the ethnic from since ancient times, okay, as a curry, because if we have it, then our bowel will be clear. There will be no that means bowel-related problem. But we try to synthesize silver and gold nanoparticle by utilizing it, and we have seen it has a very that means good effect against the plant pathogen as well as human pathogen like Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Escherichia coli, and Bacillus cereus. So this has been published. If anybody is interested, they can download it and they can go through that papers. And these are few of the nanoparticles synthesized from the botanicals. So for all my this work, I want to acknowledge my team. Okay, first row is the PhD student, second row is the MSc student, and this arrow mark, okay, these are the student at the staffs who are at present working with me. So I would like to thank, I would like to acknowledge all my student friends, research scholars, okay, who helped me to reach up to this stage. Over that, overall, I would like to acknowledge my farming community, my say funding agencies, my authority of Assam Agriculture University, present authority of Central Agriculture University, my family members, as well as special thanks go to the organizer, more particularly dynamic dean of College of Horticulture and Forestry, Dr. B.N. Hajarika sir, then co-chairman Dr. Raja, then organizing secretary Dr. Punavati, and the other dynamic organizing committee member like Dr. Singh, Dr. Victoria, Dr. Sunmina, and my dear participant for your patience hearing. Thank you all.
Yeah, thank you so much, sir, for highlighting your work on this biocontrol, bioformulation, and synthesis, development, and multiplication and application. And in this present context, organic farming is emphasized on all the northeastern states. keeping in view, all of them are would like to go for this organic production. So in this SRS narrated very nicely on this how to produce this Trichoderma viridi, and then he has told that's how it is more effective against a different pathogen. So this Trichoderma, it is effectively used to manage the pathogens in the horticulture and agriculture sector. So all the plants, if you find this in northeastern states, there are a lot of new emerging diseases and other. So to manage all the diseases, so as he has nicely illustrated with a very good example of this Trichoderma viridi, and also he has emphasized on use of other microbial fungi, Metarhizium anisophilae, and then Bovariana baciana, and effective against a lot of pests, particularly tea, and even other aphids and many other crop pests. So thank you so much, sir. So most of them are like entrepreneur seeker. Today morning also, one of the entrepreneur seeker, she called me, and she was more interested in going for this mass multiplication. So keeping their demand, so what are the medium can we use it for mass multiplication at a farmer's level? Because they want to go for any entrepreneur, they want to go for mass multiplication. Of course, they get the information from you. The microorganism from you, because some of them are patented, so they can obtain the things from you. And can you briefly explain, sir, what are the medium can we use it for this Trichoderma and for Metarhizium, and then even for this Bovariana, up to their mass multiplication at the entrepreneur level?
Okay, this is a very important question. For you see, whatever my experience I do have at lab level, it's okay. But at farmers level, I have tested around 24 different type of agrovast. And during my study, I have seen the material or the agrovast or the substrate which have good amount of say cellulose or the sugar, so that can be utilized for say mass production of Trichoderma, especially Trichoderma at the farmer's level. But for Bovaria, so we need some extra thing, because Bovaria is the organism they love chitin. So we have to search some material which have this chitin, or chitin should be added in any type of substrate, okay, at some doses, the dose that we have standardized, right? So Bovaria can be mass multiplied in the rice husk, sawdust, and rice bran at a ratio of 4:3:1 with 700 ml of water per say kg, where we have to add around 2% of the chitin. So after sterilization, that can be utilized for mass multiplication of Bovaria baciana. Even for say your Trichoderma, I'm giving you one example, any say agrovast, as I say, say you can use your sawdust, okay, number one, number two, rice straw, number three, your wheat bran. So this type of product they can use at their farmers level. Many a times, many farmers, they can use if FYM or vermicompost is available. So in that also, this Trichoderma can be mass multiplied at their farmers level. Okay, small some technical guidance they need. After getting that guidance, definitely they can multiply at their farmers level, as we did in many area of our northeastern region. If they need my help, they can directly contact Dr. Raja sir to you, and we can talk and we can train them in that aspect, right? But please try to remember, almost all the agricultural waste can be utilized for mass multiplication of this type of bioformulation, biocontrol, as an especially Trichoderma. Even we can use spent tea waste, even we can use mushroom bed spent like that. So that type of thing already we did. As I said, 22 different substrate we have tested. Okay, Dr. Raja, am I audible? Is it clear?
Yeah. Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you so much. Because they were keen on mass multiplication.
You are not audible.
Yeah.
Yeah, now audible.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, briefly explain, because so other participant, it's a time open for you. So please interact with Pranav sir if you have any queries and information, if you need any additional information. So the time is given open to all the participant. I will unmute so that you can interact with this sir. So if you have any questions also, you can type it in the chat box. Let me see that. Any questions in the chat box? Okay, participant, please interact with him if you have any query. Unmute yourself and you can ask.
I'm very much sorry that I have taken too much of time, probably. Dr. Raja,
yeah, am I right? You have maintained the time. No, you have maintained the time. Yeah.
Okay.
Good morning, sir.
Dear participant, yeah.
Sir, good morning, sir. How to get the, develop the product, which is related to biological control agents, whether they are going to give CAB for registration. So because those are also very important, when you develop the product, no, we have to get the permission from the CAB to release as a product. How to get it, because we are also following the same thing, but we didn't get the registration due to we have not yet registered that product. So how to get it, that's what sir we are asking.
Okay, that is a very good question and timely question, because almost all the institute, they are facing this type of problem. And registration is a very hectic thing. And it is a time consuming, okay? Many formalities we have to do. And then your say toxicity data, we have to develop, generate, right, Dr. Mahesh? Okay,
yes.
So here what happened, that thing we are giving, that is our Central Agricultural University. We are going to sign MOU within this month with one company that is known as JEBS. So they will look after this thing in collaboration with other company who are going to procure our product. So that risk we are not taking. As you say it, rightly say it, registration is a big problem. Since many years, I am also facing this thing. So after signing MOU with for four of my product for with Green Biotech, I told them they have registered like that. So similarly, the very recently we have developed few product. This product we are going to give to JEBS, J-E-V-E-S, and they are going to look after those matter. Generation of the toxicity data, number one. Number two, your licensing. Number three, registration. That tricks we are not taking. So you see, as a scientist, how much we will do? You have to isolate it. You have to identify the potentiality. You have to do small scale lab trial, pilot field trial, farmers field trial, okay? Then demonstration. Then when this registration part comes now, it becomes a very big problem. Am I right? So that's why we are going to give that responsibility to some company, okay?
Okay, so thank you, sir.
That part we are not taking risk.
Okay,
you can do. You can also talk with Anna Amma Association of Maharashtra, JEBS of West Bengal, like that many companies are there who are helping us a lot in this regard. Okay, sir?
Sure, sir. Thank you. Thank
okay,
you
so Dr. Much. Mahesh? Okay.
Hello, good morning, sir. My name is Mutum Dinuni, and I'm a past student of this CAU Imphal. Sir, I would like to ask about this metarism. Sir, as you have told us that metarism is helpful for this ladybug species, so there will be no harm at all after eating this dead aphid.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Hello. Okay, it do not have, because even what is your name? Mutum, right? Even you see, because of limitation of that time, I could not able to show many things. We have tested, you see, against honeybee, as I said, against praying mantid, and four different species of Trichogramma. then around six different parasites as well as predator and some natural enemies that are said by entomologists is are important for our ecosystem. So with the help of our entomologists, we did that work and we have found these are safe to some of the beneficial insect like praying mantid, earthworm, as I said, then your some beetles. Okay, so that much if you want to work in this line, that Mutum, so you have to see, we have to see this type of thing. Otherwise blindly we cannot say this will be effective against this one, but not harmful for non-target one. They should be target specific. Without that it will create problem to our, not only to our system, it will also create problem the whole ecosystem. Okay, it may disturb the in maintaining the ecological balance, right? So that is a good question. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
And all the participants, please, I request you, you can, for any type of help, if I can help you for some of your research work or formulating any project or say doing such type of work, you can take my phone number, you can ask me. I will be rather happy to share my experiences with you, okay? So otherwise what happened, everybody who used to attend this type of webinar meeting, after that we used to forget. But please try to keep link with the, especially the organizer and then this resource person. Then it will be helpful for you, especially the student friends and new budding scientists, right?
Yeah, any other question from the participant?
Yeah, 70 participants are there. They can raise any question, try to answer their question.
So, any participants, any query? Any query, please, or you can drop a message in the chat box. Okay, I think sir, your well experienced and your well presentation, I think all of can understand very quickly. So thank you so much, sir, for sharing well-to-do work in vast area and presenting in a specific topic of a beneficial effects of using microorganism, which are very much mandatory in setting up of organo-based technology, which are very much demands in today's era. So we are very much interested, and everyone is awaiting for listening your presentation and your work from minute to macro. And thank you so much, sir, for fulfilling our team. And again, we are grateful for the time and effort you took to share your thoughts and experience in various fields regarding this bioformulation. Since we are entering a new broad phase of technology-based organo production, your today's presentation is very timely for us, opening everyone's eyes. I believe we can benefit immediately from the method you suggested and hope to give good and best fruitful results soon. Thank you again. Thank you so much, sir, for your big contribution. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Once again, I would like to thank the organizing secretary.
Okay, thank you so
much. As well as co-chairman and chairman of that webinar.
Okay, thank you, sir. So I want to request to all the participants that the next section will be start from 2:30, but you have to join it from 2 p.m. So try to join it and we will be interact at that hours. Thank you so much.
2:30.
Okay.